In the third lecture, you are going to learn basic greetings in Turkish language. In my personal opinion, this is the most important course in any language. Why? Because these are the phrases and words that you are using most of the time in your daily life, and these are the phrases and words that make connection between people. When I go abroad, or when you go abroad, what do you say mostly? We say, hello, good morning, how are you, good evening, I'm sorry, thank you, goodbye. This is the lecture in which you will learn these words in Turkish language and you will make your first contact with Turkish people. Greetings change with the time of day in Turkey, just as in many other cultures in the world. Today, we are going to learn how to greet people at different times and at different contexts. In the mornings, you can greet people by saying günaydın. It means the day is clear. If you are in a more conservative part of Turkey, or if you just want to say it in a different way, you can also say hayırlı sabahlar. If the morning passes and it is, let's say, 1 p.m. or 2 p.m., we can use günaydın or iyi günler. Usually, Turkish people, they don't use günaydın. The last time I used it was when I was in primary school and we were using it to our teacher after the noon break. And after that, I haven't used it again. So you don't need to learn günaydın. But iyi günler is a very good greeting because you can use it at any time of the day and it means good days. If you just want to say hi or hello, you can use those greetings. Merhaba, which is hello, or you can say selam, which is like hi in English, or if you are in a more conservative part of Turkey, you can say selamun aleyküm. When you are leaving, there are many ways to say goodbye in Turkish. You can say görüşürüz, which means see you later, or you can say hoşça kal, which means stay well. If it is an early time of the day, you can say iyi günler, which means have a good day. Or you can say iyi geceler if it is the night time, which means good night. To get someone's attention or to apologize, you can use these phrases. Özür dilerim. Özür dilerim means I apologize. You can use it to get someone's attention. For example, özür dilerim. Can you look? Or you can use it to apologize. Özür dilerim. I'm sorry. Also, you can use alternative phrases such as affedersiniz, which means excuse me. Again, you can use it to get someone's attention or you can use it to apologize. Also, many Turkish people, they use pardon. Normally, it's a French word, but it's also widely used in Turkish. So, people, when they want to apologize or when they want to get someone's attention, they also usually say pardon. In addition to the greetings, there are also some words in the Turkish language which show respect. In Turkish culture, respect is very important and depending on the age and relationship, people use these respect words in their daily life. For example, abi and abla. Abi means elder brother and abla means elder sister. However, we are using those words a lot during our daily conversation with people that are not in our family line. For example, if you are going inside a shop, you can say merhaba abi if the shopkeeper is a man. Or you can say merhaba abla if the shopkeeper is a woman. There is also amca and teyze. Amca means uncle and teyze means aunt. And we are also using these words if the age difference is high and the other person is elderly. For example, in the metro station, if you want to get the attention of someone which is older than you, you can say affedersiniz amca. Or if you want to apologize, you can say özür dilerim teyze. Let's go over these greeting words. Listen to me carefully and repeat after me. Merhaba. Merhaba. Selam. Selam. Selamun aleyküm. Selamun aleyküm. Günaydın. Günaydın. Hayırlı sabahlar. Hayırlı sabahlar. İyi günler. İyi günler. İyi akşamlar. İyi akşamlar. Görüşürüz. Görüşürüz. Hoşça kal. Hoşça kal. İyi geceler. İyi geceler. Özür dilerim. Özür dilerim. Affedersiniz. Affedersiniz. Abi. Abi. Abla. Abla. Amca. Amca. Teyze. Teyze. Proper pronunciation of these greeting words might be a little bit difficult in the beginning. However, as you practice more, you will feel more confident and you will pronounce them better. Every time you go to the street or you meet a new person in Turkey, you can try practicing these greeting words. So, keep practicing, and if people try to correct your sentences and if they try to correct your pronunciation, consider it as a positive feedback, and I'm sure within a few weeks you will pronounce them perfectly.